Welcome to the Windows Club. If you wish to delete downloaded, failed and pending Windows updates, either read through this article on the Windows Club or simply watch this video, we will guide you through the resolution. The first solution is to delete the contents of the temporary folder. I'll show you how this is done. Press the Windows key and R to open the run window. Type the command temp and hit enter. You would need administrator permissions for this. Click on any file, press Ctrl plus A to select all files, hit delete. Click on continue. This will delete all the temporary files except for the ones currently in use. Next, you can remove the pending XML file from the path C drive Windows WinSBX folder. So let's go there. C drive Windows, scroll down to WinSBX folder. Now the XML files would be at the very end of the page. For example, this is the XML file for my folder. Simply right click on it and select delete. This needs administrator permissions. Next, you would need to delete the contents of the software distribution folder. But since you cannot do it directly, you would have to stop a few services and then delete the content. Later, you can reactivate these services. To delete the contents of the software distribution folder, type the word command in the Windows search bar, select run as administrator. This will open the elevated command prompt window. Now copy this command to stop the Windows update service and paste it in the administrator window. Hit enter. Copy this command to stop the background intelligence transfer service and hit enter. Then go to C drive, go to Windows, scroll down to the software distribution folder, select the contents and hit delete. This will need administrator permissions. Once you have deleted them, now you can restart the services in question. This is the command to restart the Windows update service. And this is the command to restart the background intelligence transfer service. Lastly, if all the above solutions fail to help you, you can consider resetting the catroot2 folder, which has been explained as the fourth solution in this article. It's a little longer procedure. If you still have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.